Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about class definitions and object-oriented programming, or OOP. I will also give you an example using coin tossing. Here are some basics. A Python object is a convenient representation of a real-world object. It may contain data and the ways to manipulate the data. The data are stored in instance variables, and the ways of manipulating the data are called methods. A class defines a type of objects. An object is just one instance of a class. I'll use coin tossing to further explain classes and object-oriented programming. A US quarter coin has two sides, heads and tails. We want to design a coin class that has the following attributes. Side is an instance variable. It stores the information of which side is currently on top. GetSide is a method. It resembles an activity that we observe which side is on top currently. Toss is a method. It simulates a toss of the coin and updates the side on top randomly. SetSide is a method that purposely puts a specific side on top. The class definition is in coins.py. This Python file is located in the same folder as this Jupyter notebook. Let's open this file in the Jupyter editor and take a look at the source code. The first two lines are comments. They briefly explain what this program does. This is a class definition of a coin. Next, we import rand int function from the random library, because we will use the randint function to generate random integer numbers later in the class definition. Class is the keyword for class definition. It is followed by a capital letter coin, which is a class name. This line ends with a colon. The body of the class definition must be indented. I use four spaces for indentation. Now we define a function called dunder init dunder. This is an object constructor. We also call it the initialization method. It must be written exactly like this, and it's case sensitive, so don't change any letter to the uppercase. A function inside a class is called a method. The first parameter of any method is always self. Later, when an object instance is created, it represents the object itself. Side is an instance variable in this class. We initialize it in this way. Self.side equals heads. It means when a coin object is created, it is showing heads on top initially. The getSide method is very simple. It will just return self.side, the currently side that is on top. The toss method will use the randint function to pick one out of these two numbers, 0 and 1, randomly. It temporarily stores the random number in this temp variable. Note we didn't use self.temp, so this variable is not an instance variable. It is just a local variable and will disappear after this function execution is finished. If temp is equal to 1, we set the side to heads. Otherwise, it means the temp is 0, we set it to tails. Side is an instance variable. It remembers the object state. Even if the toss function execution is finished, the side value is still there and will not disappear. The setSide method has two parameters, self and the side string. It will set the side to the side string passed by the user. Now let's switch back to the Jupyter notebook. We want to use the coin class we defined in coin.py. We need to import coin from coin. The capital letter coin is a class name, and the lowercase letter coin is a Python file name without the .py extension. Next, we create a coin object C using the class name coin and a pair of empty parentheses. Instance variables and methods are accessed by name using dot notation. We use the dot notation like this to access the instance variable c.side. We know its initial value is heads. It is equivalent to this c.getSide method. The result is also heads. After that, we toss the coin using the toss method. Then we see which side is on top. This time is tails. Toss it again, heads. If we toss it many times, on average, we will have 50% chance of seeing heads and the other 50% chance of seeing tails. Finally, we set the side to tails manually. When a method is called, we always omit the first self parameter and only provide other normal parameters. In this case, the side string is tails. Observe the results after we set the side. We can confirm that now it's tails. Okay, I talked about class definitions and the object-oriented programming using the coin tossing example in this video. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.